I would just love to add, you know, Chris Middleton to the pile of experimentation. Let's see what more you can get.
As you mentioned, that the Giannis thing and seeing it last night, I actually saw Giannis in person last night, and I saw the Bucks, which Drew Holiday has not come back completely. He'd only been back a couple of games, and they are bringing him off the bench. But I was left watching that game last night thinking, you know, he makes these massive winning plays down the stretch, and you view that through the prism of what the Bucks, how the Bucks can be different when it comes playoff time. And it is the huge difference. And this is like what I witnessed last night. I was glad in some ways that I got to witness this, because when most people have, you know, the Bucks are more of an afterthought now than certainly they were last year, because everybody's on the, you got to prove it. But that is a different deal than it is with Bledsoe. You know, when he's there. I mean, you saw the difference, which is this is a guy that can make the huge plays when it matters most. And he is the perimeter guy that can make the huge plays when it matters most. And I know you just did this video about Middleton, but I walked out of that game going, I don't know if there's going to be a big difference in Middleton when it comes playoff time. Like, I kind of feel like he is what he is. But the last time we saw Holiday in the playoffs, that Pelicans team was wearing out the Blazers, and he was better in the playoffs than he was during the regular season. Unfortunately, Middleton has been significantly worse. He had that disastrous series against the Raptors a couple of years ago. The numbers aren't as good when it's come playoff time, but Holiday gives them an element, and I think you saw it for anybody that had that game on last night.
The steal
makes that makes them different like that. It really does. I think he is a big time player, and come playoff time, he might be able to be the thing that gets the Bucks over the hump.
Yeah, man. I feel like with Milwaukee, they've been sort of overlooked for understandable reasons, because we have all these new teams. Philly's looks different now. Embiid's having an MVP season. The Nets obviously have KD back and Kyrie back and James Harden now. You have some teams that are underwhelming in the East, like the Celtics are underwhelming compared to expectations. The Heat are. And then Milwaukee's just sort of, like you said, people just want, well, they're really good, and then people just want to wait to see it. That's they want to wait till the playoffs. It's like you're not overreacting to the regular season. But what the regular season has shown is that this team is doing different things. On defense, they're switching screens more often, especially when they have Giannis at the five. So they're not just sticking to their drop defensive scheme that they've used for a couple of years with Brook Lopez that has been exploited in the playoffs. On offense, they're putting guys in the dunker spot near their baseline more often to differentiate what they do. Sometimes they have everybody behind the line, you know, four out spacing. Sometimes they only have three out with the guy in the dunker spot. They're running a little bit more pick and roll with Giannis as a screener. And it's Drew Holiday. You know, it's Chris Middleton and Drew Holiday being used as the pick and roll ball handler with Giannis Antetokounmpo. And Holiday, you saw last night that you had great defense by Eric Bledsoe. What you didn't have was great offense. He's a solid spot up shooter during the regular season. Not a guy you give the ball to go get you a bucket. Drew Holiday, no timeouts left, brings the ball up the court and comfortably gets into a shot. And that is going to have to be the difference for the Bucks. What can Drew Holiday and Chris Middleton both do as perimeter shot creators in tough fourth quarter moments when the defense is locked in, the game slowed down, you're not able to get what you want to get to, maybe with Giannis or maybe your typical motion, you know? Can those guys get you a bucket? They're better there this season. Yes. They're better than they were in the past. And that's where, like with the Chris Middleton video I did this week that you mentioned, that's where I feel like Milwaukee, There's more that they can get out of Middleton and Drew Holiday. And I wonder if they'll hold it until the playoffs to do it. But we did see the flash last night of what they could be with Holiday. It was awesome.
And like, it's so odd because, like you say, you know, people get fatigued talking about something like the Giannis thing, right? There's a reason that people were saying he'd have to average like 50 and 20 to be in the MVP conversation, because people are over it, right? Because they gave the MVP again, and then he didn't do well in the playoffs, whether it's his fault or not. I mean, I watched a team that did not have a good matchup for him. did as good a job as they could have possibly done against that guy. And you still look up at the end of the night, he's got 26 points.
Yeah.
Like, that's how, I mean, he is a absolute force of nature. Again, they're just getting Holiday back into it. But I do think when I, you know, you and I got this argument at the beginning of the year, and I said, you know, I just don't think Middleton can be your second best guy going up against these teams. Holiday might.
Holiday might be, yeah.
He might. He might be able to be your second best guy, depending on, because he is, like, it's funny. You did that video, and you talked about him being maybe the most underrated player in the NBA. It's funny, because Holiday might be, too. You know what I mean? Like, if it's not one of them, you're right. If we're talking about underrated players, and Holiday obviously does not have the all-star appearances, you know, a bunch of all-star appearances. He is one of those guys that's kind of been in that class of everybody acknowledges he's a fantastic player, but he doesn't always get rewarded for being a fantastic player in that tier below the Currys and the Lillards and the Pauls and whatever, kind of like Conley was. But, you know, it's when you watch them, you can see that's the difference. Like, that's why they gave up all those picks. It's why they gave up so much in so many people's minds for Jrue Holiday, is because he might, I mean, the upgrade from Bledsoe to him is extreme offensively.
For sure. I mean, no doubt it's extreme for them. And Jrue Holiday's playmaking is better too, for that matter. It's, you know, not just defense, not just, you know, scoring, it's playmaking. And with Chris Middleton, like, the usage of the word underrated, part of me did that because, I mean, obviously he wasn't voted an all-star, you know, this season by coaches or, you know, but also I still wonder if, like, is he underrated even by the Bucks, even by himself? He gets 15 shots a game, Chris, when he's one of the most efficient scorers in the league shooting off the dribble. And I would love to see what happens if he has 2 or 3 weeks or a month straight of 18, 19 shots every night. If that's what he's getting, I would just love to see what happens. Maybe you get diminishing returns because he's not like the silkiest ball handler. He's not the guy who gets to the basket all the time and lives at the free throw line. But the dude just drains jumpers off the dribble, like, no matter how hands are in his face, no matter how covered he is. I would just love to see what the production is with 3 more shots. Because I think there's more that the Bucks can get out of him if they want to get it out of him. So more than anything else, I would just love to see the Bucks experiment with that for, you know, a couple of weeks. This is what the team, like, Giannis himself said, they're using the regular season as practice for switching on defense. And you can see them doing it. Like, they have screwed up a lot on switches, botched switches. And they've had situations where guys are getting attacked relentlessly, which is one of the concerns with, like, DJ Augustine in a playoff situation. One of the concerns with, like, Pat Connaughton in certain playoff situations. But the point is that this team is still winning a lot of games, is number 3 in the league in net rating when they're practicing, and they're admitting that they're practicing during the regular season. So I would just love to add, you know, Chris Middleton to the pile of experimentation. Let's see what more you can get.